Good day, folks. My name's Raymond Moore, and I'm here with the RV Corral in beautiful, sunny Eugene, Oregon, where you can't beat a day like today. I'm here to show you and tell you some of the really nice features with the 2012 Fusion. This is a brand new model for them. It's a 301, so you're not going to find it in any brochure. You'll probably have to go onto their website for the floor plan. What's really unique with this floor plan, folks, is we have two slide outs in the living room, and I also have a 10-foot garage in the back end. Wow, I know, tremendous. These Fusion people are great. Up in the front, there's really not much to tell. I have my two large propane tanks, and with the slide outs, we do fit them with two deep cycle house batteries. Diamond plating on the front end. We have aluminum framing construction. This is going to be a very large storage area that goes completely underneath over to the other side, and also we can access it from the bedroom area, which I'll show you when we go inside. 6-gallon gas electric hot water heaters. If you want the recovery to be quicker, then you just turn it on both gas and electric. Of course, if you don't need it to recover that quick and you're plugged in paying for 110 power, then just leave it on 110, conserve your propane. Outside in here, this side we have the slide out that comes out right in here. And one nice thing about them, they use these, I call them wiper blades, and that is they're not glued in. So if we need to replace these, we just take out a screw here, screw at the top, pull them out. Like a wiper blade, you just put in a brand new set and away you go. Notice how this is gray too. So when this is resting against this molding here, it's not going to leave a black mark on there because they make sure that it's gray and not black. Outside, we've got some kicker outside stereo speakers. And the stereo system on this, folks, really puts out a lot of sound. Fresh water connection over here, and I have my cable outlet with a 110 outside furnace. Nothing really to show you here. I have the tandem axle, and they both have braking on them. This is going to be my entrance to the garage from the outside. Sorry, Curtis. I'll show you more of that when we go inside. But rubber matting, very nice. A lot of nice tie downs with this product, and I have a triple step going in. Notice my strut is holding this door open, so I don't have to worry about those little festy latches to keep my door open, and they do that on both doors. Have an awning up above. It's a power awning, so I can control it with the switch. On the back here, I have my labels, and this one just came in, folks. I haven't even, my tie-dye, I haven't even snapped it off, so unfortunately I'm not going to be able to show you the gate on this. Couple of nice things, LED lighting down below, springs located in the base of the aluminum framed garage door, and then I have my large floodlights on the back end. Now on some of my Fusions, this door will actually come down and I can pivot it like a veranda straight out. It has some tie straights that comes down and keeps it out like a veranda. And then again, you could put an awning up there to come out like a patio awning if you wanted to. Just a suggestion. Over on this side over here, we have the fuel docking station. It's unleaded fuel, and I do believe it's about a 26-gallon tank. And I have my pump system. This is a 12-volt pump system, so I can fuel up my ATVs, my motorcycle, whatever I need to fuel up. And then I have a city water connection right down in here. Satellite cable hookups are right in here. And I do have right down in here 50 amp marine grade exterior hookup for my 110. Here I have another slide out, and I don't know if you can see that, but we have a double gasket on these wiper blades. I have the main one on the outside, and then I have a secondary on the inside. So even if a twig gets in between, they're going to hit another stripe on the inside, another blade, I should call it. Matte finish on the outside. Really nice finish on the exterior. Down in here, I've got my outside shower, hot and cold water, and it does come with a 15-foot water hose. Place to put my sewer hose, and in the front here, I have my built-in 4,000 watt, excuse me, upgraded 5,500 watt Onan generator. Standard is the 4,000 watt. Let's wow them, Curtis, with the inside of this. I don't know of anybody else yet that is building a pool toy hauler, a travel trailer, that has a couple of slides and a built-in garage. So folks, you're probably asking, well, this thing must weigh a ton. And it does. It weighs 9,240 pounds dry. But the guy that's going to pull this is going to have a heavy-duty 3/4 ton, 1 ton, something big enough to pull it down the road. Nice galley area here. Completely out of the way. I don't have to worry about moving if somebody wants to get by me. I have my double-door fridge on this side, which is the automatic, so it switches from propane to 110. I have a nice little microwave up above with a high-output 3-burner stove and a gas oven. With this island here, notice the counter space. I can put my coffee pot over here. I can put my toaster over here. I have some nice storage down below. And then I have these, what they call full extension drawers. They'll come out all the way. And then again to the left, I have another camera. If you can see that there, Curtis. More storage up above. Everywhere you look in this galley, we have storage. To the front over here, notice I have a really nice high-quality Sony flat-screen TV. I have a 760 Jensen Power Boost. I have my AM/FM stereo, CD, DVD player. Over here I have my gen start with my gen hours for the generator. Every 50 hours you need to change oil. My slide-out buttons are right in here. And then, I don't know if you can, this actually, with these doors closed, and again, excuse me a little bit, folks, but I have a sliding door on each end. When my doors are closed, I can take this TV and pivot it around to where I can now watch TV from the bedroom. The bed in the front of these are a queen-size bed. Very, very comfortable, very nice mattresses. They're not just a RV mattress, they're an upgraded mattress. And I have my ducted air conditioning up above, which goes through and ducts everything inside the toy hauler. Not that we need all these extra beds, but this pulls out here. I've got an extra cushion, extra tables. This is an air, hide-a-bed air mattress. Nice big windows. Notice I got my blackout shades. And I have windows. So I can get cross ventilation going here. Okay, here's this exciting part, folks. I'm going to let Curtis show you the bathroom in this one while I step into the garage. Nice little tub shower. Sink, bathroom, stool. Okay, keep in mind, this is a trailer. It's not a fifth wheel. So we have a 10-foot garage in this area. And up above here, I have my two full-size beds that go up into the ceiling. Although you can't see it here, I have a table that folds down so I can remove the table from the middle if I want to and take it outside. Or just leave it inserted in here. And makes into a full bed. So kids, guys that want to go hunting, they have extra room. Technically 2, 4, 6, 8 is very, very comfortable for sleeping in. All my tie downs, like I'd mentioned, and my ramp is dovetailed. So for those guys that have Harley Davidsons, bikes, it's very easy to come into the garage itself without scraping the bottom of the bike. Big windows again on this side, big windows again on that side. Just an awful lot of trailer. Notice I have AC ducts coming in here, and then down on the floor I have heat ducts coming in. And again, if you compare that with a lot of the toy haulers out there, they're not going to have heat ducts coming into this garage. Storage up above, and over in this wall over here I've got an area where I could mount a flat screen TV, my outlet coming in from the antenna, plus my 110 plugs. This is a brand new 2012, folks, and we're really excited to be a Fusion dealer here in Eugene, Oregon. I invite you to stop in. If you do, just ask for me by name. Very easy, Raymond Moore. If not, just ask for the Englishman. That'll get me. We've been here 25 years and we're not going anywhere. Call me, email me, any questions whatsoever. We're here with Yavi Corral in Eugene, Oregon. Thank you for watching the video and have a great day.